I've never been someone that's entrepreneurial at all until my circumstances changed. In 2020, my older brother passed away. That put life in a different perspective for me. In a weird way, it kind of grew my confidence and showed me the fragility of life. From there, I did a sea turtle monitoring program. It was one of the most magical experiences of my life. And after that, I only really wanted to work for sea turtles. So I ended up signing up for a course in environmental science at Curtin University, Western Australia.
Hey Dad, is it just the one with the red strap you want?
I grew up in Perth, Western Australia, which is, I guess you call it a coastal town. Been kind of brought up in a family where photographic expeditions is the fun thing to do together. Weirdly, in a way, it's come full circle in that we spot turtles, uses photography as one of the main components. Essentially, it allows members of the public to upload images of sea turtles they've spotted in the wild.
I thought maybe we could talk through a few of the features.
These images are then photo recognised and a trail of movement is then collected as the sea turtle is spotted around the world. I would definitely say We Spot Turtles is a very unusual business. I think you'd probably be hard-pressed to find a company where two co-founders haven't met. But given that Nick and I live on opposite sides of the world, with the technology that's available to us, the Google collaboration tools, we're able to essentially meet online, and it works.
We're all set for Exmouth, and I'm really looking forward to meeting you in person. It's going to be super fun.
I'm a mobile application developer, and I use Flutter framework. Google Play was a good place to release our application and to make the project great.
Without Google Play, we wouldn't have the ability to connect on such a global scale.
Hello.
Hello.
How are you?
When Nick first reached out to me, to be honest, I was a bit skeptical. I received this random message, but when I looked through Nick's profile, I noticed that he had 20 years of experience, that he had photos of him doing sea turtle monitoring in the past. So I kind of went, okay, he is a real human being.
I always wanted to make something to help the sea turtle. So I have the idea of an application.
Given the advancements in AI in recent years, we have an opportunity to make a bigger impact than we traditionally would be able to with other methods. The way we see it is to be on the side of AI and to be using it to actually engage communities.
Look, there's two there.
There are 7 species of sea turtle and all are endangered or quote-unquote data deficient, which means there's not even enough data on them to inform an accurate endangerment status. But a sea turtle's carapace and their facial scales are unique, similar to human fingerprint. So the machine learning model that Nicolas has created uses the carapace and the facial scale pigmentations to not only identify the species of the sea turtle, but also that sea turtle uniquely. There's some massive issues with the current monitoring processes. When I did my monitoring, we were tagging about 100 sea turtles a night. But if you're able to just take photos and upload photos, that could be thousands. Because We Spot Turtles puts data collection in the hands of the people, we actually think that the data set growth would be exponential.
Hey, Sarah.
Hello.
How are you going?
We're really trying to create a community-driven app. Because it's not only in the hands of small groups of government-trained individuals, it's actually in the hands of everyone. Anyone can make an impact in sea turtle conservation.